All right. Man, Brother Philip said we're talking about Samson. Ah! Where did that come from?
All those muscles, and you still a big scaredy cat.
Hey, don't be making fun of my muscles. I've been working on these things all week. But wow. Philip said, we're talking about Samson today.
Oh, I thought he said salmon.
No.
I have like 8 fish in an ice chest back there.
No. Okay. Is that the snow that I walked in? It smells kind of stinky in here.
No, that was just
I thought I was strong, but actually the strongest thing in here right now is that smell. Ugh.
I'm sorry.
But let me tell you, I've been working out really hard all week, getting nice and strong for today.
Oh, you got some gains.
Yeah, lots of gains.
You just lift the hammer?
No, this is just a...
Let me see.
Yes.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, please take it back. Oh, my word.
So, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, my
goodness.
We're
strong. We're strong. Just like Samson.
Just like Samson. I'm not strong like Samson. I'm definitely not strong. Oh, man. I can't believe I misprepared. Okay, so if we're going to talk about Samson, about like strong and he didn't have integrity. So don't have integrity. Just like Samson didn't have integrity. He kind of did whatever he wanted. And
I think we're going to talk about his guns today. Ooh. And I brought, you know what?
That can't be it. That we can't talk.
Did you buy your ticket today?
My ticket.
Yeah, your ticket.
To
this gun show.
What is going on here, guys?
No.
What are you doing?
I'm getting ready for my Samson.
Oh my god. What is that?
It's
what? No, these are balloons.
That's why they look so funny.
Did you really stick balloons in your shirt?
Yes.
That's pathetic.
You know what? Hey, that actually fits into what we're talking about there, Brother Julian. We're talking about Samson and how his strength was in himself, or he thought it was.
Ooh.
When really it came from
the ceiling.
No, it came from God, not the ceiling.
Oh, God.
So, Brother Julian, you don't get your strength from balloons. You get it from working out. Samson.
I got a lot to learn today.
So we aren't talking about don't have integrity like Samson.
No!
Oh.
We want integrity.
I was thinking you were going crazy.
You guys, okay. We're talking about how all strength source is
God.
From God.
Okay.
Oh. Whatever strength you think, whether that's intelligence, strength of mind, or strength of body,
or strength of
financial, maybe you have a lot of money.
Like me.
And you think you can rely
on
that.
Strength of smell, like him.
Did you know, just like Samson, he was strong as can be, and all of a sudden he was weak as a kitten? That actually happened. We're going to tell that story today.
Instantly?
Yes. Instantly. And God can take it away. So we got to rely on God's strength. That's what we're talking about today. All strength comes from him.
Wow.
Not from us.
All right. Well, I got a lot to learn. Because clearly, I mean, I'm already headed the wrong direction.
No, you're doing all right.
Embarrassing.
I'm going to go get the fish out of here. So hopefully the smell will go away.
Get the fish? What? Okay, did I miss something?
You did.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Okay, guys, rules. Time for rules. Yeah, everybody, today, this is not a show. That's number one rule, right?
Not a show.
How about you give us rule number two?
Okay, rule number two.
She's been in Sunday school for a long time. She's got this.
When you're spotting someone at the gym, make sure you can lift the weight that they're lifting too. Because one time I was spotting for this guy that was lifting like 5 million pounds and I could only lift 2. And then he was like,
he's are you crazy?
And I picked and I dropped it right on his head.
Sister Delaney.
And I fell on him too. So
1,000, 2,000, 8,000. Just because a good idea doesn't make it a rule for Sunday school. Yes, obviously, be careful with
I had a good idea.
This is not a show. And number two, get involved. Participate. Don't just sit there and watch. You got to get up when we sing a song, you sing a song. When we ask questions, you
ask questions.
Yes. No.
Okay, number three.
I brought it back.
Don't date a guy like Samson. All bronze, no brain.
Yeah, all you girls out there, date someone that's living for God, not someone that's muscle bound.
Yeah.
And if you get both, you get lucky. I don't know. I don't know how that works. Anyway, so today we're talking about Samson and the source of all strength, right?
Yes.
Okay, so that's the rule. Now, we have 2 birthdays today.
Oh.
They are twins all the way from Kentucky.
But do they have 2 different birthdays? It was like one born at like 11:59 and the other born at 12:01?
Oh. No, they're born on the same day.
Oh.
Oh.
Okay, share
they are Lanaya and Leanna Robinson.
Happy birthday. Feliz cumpleaños. Something on
the audio. All the way from Kentucky Fried Chicken?
No.
Is there Dad Colonel Sanders?
I'm sorry. We are so happy that you guys watched Sunday School.
Are they turning 13? or 11. What is it? 11 herbs and spices, 13 herbs and spices. I forget what it is.
I'm really sorry. They're kind of nuts, but happy birthday anyway. Ready? Let's see what we're cooking.
Happy birthday to you. Wow, we dropped the ball on that one.
Tata de gloria, tata de
gloria. Stola, stola, nexesenam. Hey,
feliz cumpleaños. No?
Feliz
aniversario.
Leanna. Happy birthday, even though we're all a bit crazy here. We're happy that you are a year older. You guys are awesome.
That's happy Thanksgiving.
Happy, happy birthday. We're crazy and you're two. Wait, no, she's not crazy. We're crazy.
They're not two either. Happy birthday.
Okay.
Their birthdays are on birthday March song, 20th. Very long. So 6 days from now, I think it's next Saturday is their birthday.
Wow.
All right. So, guys. We got to move on. I think we got a
Did
song right now.
Did you buy the plane tickets to fly to Kentucky? Are we going to the birthday party?
No!
But I love birthday parties.
We're not. We do not have a budget to go to Kentucky, even though it would be really cool. But we're going to sing a song instead.
I had another good idea.
What?
What if you start the song and we sing it? I like having the good ideas around here.
Okay, I'm going to go. I'm so excited. You guys just sing a song?
Yes, we're going to sing a song.
All right.
We are going to help.
Go. Again. Hey.
Hey. All right. Go.
Hey. Hey.
All right, here we go.
We will trust in God alone. We will stand upon His word, and whatever comes our way. We are strong and we are brave. His truth will be our guide through the day and the darkest night. Our God will give us strength. We are strong and we are brave, and we will stand together, stand forever. We will stand strong, standing up for God each day.
Alright, here we go again.
We will trust in God alone. We will stand upon His word, and whatever comes our way, we are strong and we are brave. His truth will be our guide through the day and the darkest night. Our God will give us strength. We are strong and we are brave, and we will stand together, stand forever. We will stand strong, standing up for God each day. We will stand strong, and we will stand together, stand forever. We will stand strong, standing up for God each day. We will stand strong, yeah. We will stand strong. Hey.
Okay, I've sang that song a million times. I've never got the last hey right.
I got it right.
I mess it up every time.
You did. That was
and
awful.
I'm getting sick of messing it up. But someone that doesn't mess up is Brother Bob Lee.
Oh.
Brother Bob Lee is going to give us an object lesson talking about strength. Brother Lee, can you help us?
I'll sure try.
So we're learning about Samson and yes. how his strength came from God, but he didn't admit it. And he actually lost his strength because he didn't do what God wanted him to do.
All right.
So Brother Lee, what do we got today?
Yes. All right, well, you mind helping me a little bit?
Yes, if you promise I will not lose a limb.
All right, I promise.
Okay.
All right, so I don't know how well you're gonna see this here, but I got liquid here. Okay.
So what is this?
Okay, so I got like it kind of looks like milk.
Oatmeal.
Yeah.
I like oatmeal.
Milk. Real
it looks
liquid
like here. Gross milk.
Yeah, it's gross milk. Kind of like curdled milk. Okay.
I hope you're not having me drink this.
No, you don't have to drink it. Okay. Now, I gotta admit, Brother Phil, you're looking pretty buffed.
Woo! Come Come on now.
So kind of, you know. So anyway, I want you to, you know, on your strength, because you're strong, okay, I want you to take this rod here, okay, and you saw this liquidy stuff here?
Yeah.
Okay, it goes all the way down.
Yeah.
All right, so on your strength, I'm going to hold it for you and stand back. I should have got safety goggles. Safety is the number one priority.
What am I doing?
I want you to take that, hold that plunger, and just stab it down really hard. Okay?
Piece of cake.
Get all the way to all the
all
way.
Day. Just all day.
I'm going to hold it.
Just, ah.
Okay, ready?
Hold on. I didn't try hard enough. I wasn't even trying there. I wasn't even trying. Hold on. One, two. Yeah! Okay, that didn't work. Give me one more try. Please,
okay.
One more.
Okay, just step real hard. Get real hard.
One, two.
There you go.
Okay. It went in like a half inch.
You couldn't get it.
Someone didn't eat their
spinach.
Why don't
you work out a little bit? Do a couple jumping jacks.
Spinach.
Do like 100 push-ups. Or
do any spinach?
Why don't you try? Now, okay. Now, this young lady is...
If I couldn't get it in, she can't.
Well, but you know what, though? I think that she's not counting on her own strength, but it's somebody else. Who's your strength? I can do all things through Christ.
Who gives me strength?
Okay.
How come I messed up?
Let's just see if she can do it. Okay, go ahead.
Now I know how Delaney feels. She's always a bad example, and now I am.
So just go ahead and let's just see. You just tried it. Let's see if you can just.
She won't be able. I only got it a half inch in. There's no way she's going.
Wow, she's already like 3-4 times further down than you.
Well.
What's going on with that?
Maybe she's really strong.
Who's no? Who? Maybe it's who she's putting her.
Have you been doing like a lot of cardio?
I have been eating spinach lately.
Been eating spinach.
It's all in the spinach.
You think it's all in the spinach, or maybe somebody else is helping you with
I
your?
I think someone else is helping too.
Okay. So you know, so look, and just so I'll just mark here. Let's just see. Okay. So I don't want to spill this stuff here. All right. So look at that. So she went all the way down.
Well, it's like here. Ice cream.
Look at that. She went all the way here, Brother Philip. You went down about a half an inch.
Maybe. But that's not possible. I tried really hard, and I did it really strong, and it's not fair.
Well, you see, that's the whole point of the lesson today. Oh. Sometimes, you know, when we try to just rely on ourselves, maybe our intellect, maybe just our finances and the job that we, and if we put our trust and our faith in just those material things, you know, sometimes we're gonna fail. Okay, we need to put our trust in God. He is our strength. He's our refuge. He's our strong tower. All of our strength, everything we need to do. Like before I came to God, I tried to quit doing bad things. But you know what? I kept doing them over and over again because I didn't have the Holy Ghost in me.
That's like Samson, the story.
Exactly.
He did a lot for God, but only when he concentrated on him and did the things of God. When he tried to do it himself, they did bad things. And I poked his eyes out and made him like a camel. I'm just pushing things around.
It was awful.
I don't want to be like a camel.
Right. But like Bree here, okay, she puts her faith and trust in God.
I said, I don't want to be like a camel. You said like Bree here. That was not very nice, Brother Lee.
That wasn't very nice.
I don't think he meant it that way, though.
Okay. Okay. So anyway, everybody out there, remember, God is our strength.
God is our strength.
Okay. He can help us through no matter what the situation is. And it does. And we're not just talking, again, like physical strength, like Samson had plenty of that when God gave it to him. And then when he kind of repented and said, God, I need you. Right? The Philistines came crushing down. The tower came down.
That's pretty good, Brother Lee.
So God is our strength. We need to trust in him, and he'll be able to make everything happen that we need in our
life. That was really good. All right. I learned a lot. I don't know about you guys, but my goodness, I am going to be putting my trust and faith in God. Good job, Brother Lee. Thank you. And I'm sorry, Brie, you're not a camel.
Okay, thanks.
Wow, that was really good. Now, hey, we've been talking about Samson all day, right?
That's right.
So today, Brother Danny, can you help me out, Brother Lee?
Yes,
Sister Bree? So
right.
We're going to tell the story of Samson. So some people may not know it. I know it's something that if you've been in church for a while, then it's kind of like second nature. But this story is all about someone that was really, really strong. But when I say his name, Samson, he was strong, right? He went, oh! I need you guys to go, oh! Yeah, very good. Samson, there you go. He was born, and first of all, his parents couldn't have kids, and they finally had kids, but God made a promise and said, when I give you a child, he is going to be something special, and he's going to be a Nazarite. Now, Nazarite kind of sounds like termite, and termites is a bug, so whenever I say Nazarite, you're going to say, squash him, like that, okay, and then it's going to stomp. So he was going to be a Nazarite.
Squash him.
Yeah, very good. Squash him, and he's going to be called Samson. This is going to be fun. All right.
All right.
So he was a little baby, and he grew up, and everybody knew that he was going to be very special. But he was a Nazirite.
Squash him.
Yeah, squash him. And that meant that he was going to have to do certain things that other people could do. He couldn't eat anything that had grapes in it. He couldn't cut his long hair. Okay. Long hair. Now, whenever we talk about long hair, we're going to say, ooh la la. Okay, whenever we see talk about his hair, okay? So he had long hair.
Ooh la la.
Who did? Samson. He was a Nazirite.
Squish it.
Very good. And now the Israelites were surrounded by an evil tribe or an evil nation, and they were always beating them up. And these were the Philistines. Whenever you see Philistines, they were soldiers, and so they would go stomp, stomp, stomp. Okay? So the Philistines were not very nice people, and they always wanted to cause trouble in the Israelites. But God rose up Samson, a Nazirite, squish him, to be something special and to save his people, okay? So, guys, if you're on the other side of this camera, you need to be doing all this too, okay?
Yeah, we need your help.
Yeah, we need help because sometimes we're going to mess up, but you guys have got our back, all right? Okay, so Samson grew up, and he had strength that was just unbelievable. He was a special child, and he grew up and became stronger and stronger, and he began to do incredible things. He began to save his people from the Philistines. That's right. In fact, one day, he was walking, and a giant lion. Lions are scary. So whenever you hear the word lion, go, arr, make the roaring noise. Okay, so a lion jumped out at him. And you know what he did instead of running away like a little girl?
What did he do?
Well, he had his long hair.
Ooh la la.
He had his long hair. And so I said it again.
Ooh, oh, ooh yeah. La la.
And so it gave him special power. And so when the lion came, he was able to grab it and rip it apart with his bare hands. Ooh. And it laid on the ground. And God used that to speak to him. And he had like honey came out of it and all kinds of crazy stuff. Well, he used that for a riddle later on that we're going to talk about.
Okay, okay.
Okay? So he had special strength. Well, he was going into the Philistine camp because he had a problem.
Ooh.
Yeah, he had feet of clay, as it were. You know, he was strong, but he had, as they say, a wandering eye. He liked the Philistine girls too much. And whenever we say Philistine girls, or when we talk about one of his girlfriends, we just need to go, my love. Okay? He had a girlfriend in the Philistines.
My love.
Yeah, I know. And he had every chapter he had a different one, it seems like. This guy was in bad shape. But somehow, through our mistakes, God can still use us somehow. But he kept repenting and coming to himself, and God would forgive him. And then he would find another Philistine girl.
My love.
And get in trouble again. Yeah, and so this particular time, he found a Philistine girl. And he fell in love with her. And so how did it happen? He went to the Philistines, and they were, he made a riddle for him. And he said, if you can solve this riddle, I'm going to give you all this good stuff, okay? And so the riddle he made was something about the lion. Yeah, and he said, out of the eater came something to eat, or something like that. And out of the strong came something sweet. And you guys have to tell me what it is, and if you don't, I'm going to beat you up. Samson was a bad dude.
Yeah.
Well, they couldn't think what it was, and they really wanted to get, they didn't want to get beat up, and they wanted the good stuff that he promised them. And so they went, and they found his girlfriend.
Ooh.
My love! But Samson found out about it too late. Sorry. Samson had only told the answer to the riddle to one person, and that was his girlfriend. My love! Well, he went to her, and he told her the answer. And she went and told the Philistines the answer. And so when he found out about it, Samson got mad. And his long hair really started messing with him. And so he went and started, he just whooped up on those Philistines. And he got that girl of his, my love. And he gave her away because he said, you know, if you're going to tell all my secrets, you're in trouble. Well, over and over again, he got in trouble. In fact, one time he got so fed up, he actually caught hundreds of foxes. Ooh, wow. Can you imagine trying to catch one fox?
Yeah.
This dude was fast as well as strong. He caught foxes and tied their tails together. Can you imagine trying to tie the tail of a wild fox together? Thing would eat you alive.
Wow.
But he did. And then, Peter would not be happy with him, he dipped their tails in like oil and set them on fire. And so these foxes with their tails tied together, set on fire, he let them run through the crops of the Philistines and just burn them into pieces. Ooh. That's pretty crazy.
That's wild. Crazy.
And the Philistines, they didn't like that. And so they came to Samson over and over and tried to kill him, but they couldn't figure it out. But one day, Samson, he fell in love with a girl named Delilah. my love. And so he went over to her house, and he kept getting, he's just not a very smart guy. No. And so she knew that he had a secret, but she didn't know the secret was his long hair. Yeah, but it was, and that's where his power or his strength was held, because when he cut it, God was going to just not give him the strength anymore. Well, so he was with the Philistines. He was with Delilah.
My love.
And she said, "Please tell me your secret." And she wouldn't tell him. He said, "Please tell me your secret. You just don't love me. You just don't love me." And he said, "Oh my goodness, I feel so bad." And so he said, "All right, I'll tell you the secret. You bind me." And he started making up crazy stuff. "Bind me with these green cords, and that's going to tie me up." And so she tied him up, and the Philistines came. And they came over to Samson, and his long hair came into play. And the Spirit of God, when you hear Spirit of God, we got to say hallelujah.
All right. Okay?
The Spirit of God came
hallelujah.
On all over Samson, and he chased those Philistines, and he beat them up. And Delilah, my love, said, "You lied to me." And he said, "Yeah, kind of did." And so he made up something else crazy. He told her vines, and then he told her new ropes, and then he told her all this crazy stuff. He told her everything. In fact, at the very end, he got close to his secret. He said, "If you braid my hair a certain way." If you braid my hair a certain way. Yeah. Then I will lose all my strength. Well, he kept telling her closer and closer to the truth. Now he's talking about his hair. He told her something wrong. So she called in the Philistines, and they came in, and he called on the Spirit of God.
Hallelujah!
And his long hair came in play.
Ooh, la, la.
And he fought off those Philistines.
Ooh, la, ooh.
And he gave him a good whooping. Well, this time Delilah said, "I'm sick of this. You've lied to me one time too many. You can't lie to me again. If you do, basically it's over." And Samson says, "All right, she serves." Every guy here knows, you know when a woman serves. Well, she was serious. And so he said, "All right, if you cut my long hair, I'll lose my strength." And inside he knew, "I'm going to lose the Spirit of God." Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
No, that's not something to worship about, because that'd be terrible. But anyway, he told her the secret, and he fell asleep. And she called in a barber, and they cut his long hair.
Ooh la la.
Ooh la la. Ooh la la. They cut his long hair. And then the Philistines came in, and Samson didn't realize that his long hair had been cut off. And so he called on the Spirit of God.
Hallelujah.
But this time it wasn't there. Because his strength wasn't within himself. It was in God. And he had done the one thing, among others, the final thing that God said, "You do that, you're done." And he allowed his hair to be cut. And he lost the Spirit of God.
Hallelujah.
Well, the Philistines came in and they bound him. He was as weak as a kitten this time. There's nothing they could do. And so they took him in. Actually, guys, I hate to say this, but they put his eyes out. And they strapped him to like a grinding mill. And all he would do is just push this thing in a circle like an animal, and he would do this day after day. But the Bible says, but Samson's hair, ooh la la, began to grow again.
Oh, right.
And it began to grow. And he began to come to himself. He realized that my strength is not in me. My strength is in the Spirit of God.
Hallelujah.
His hair began to grow.
Ooh la la.
And the Philistines didn't know what was coming. They had a big party, and they thought they were going to have a big laughing stock. So they called in Samson, and they put him inside this massive palace. And they said, "Listen, we're going to strap him. We're going to put him right in the middle where we can just laugh at him all day long." But they didn't know that his hair had begun to grow. And there's a little boy there. And he said, lead me by the hand. He said, "Take me to the big pillars there in the middle." So this huge place was held up by two giant pillars in the middle. And so he said, "Place my hands on either side." Now, when I say big pillars, these pillars were massive. They were holding up this whole house. They were probably like 4 feet across. Solid stone. Can you imagine how big and heavy and solid these things were?
Yes.
But Samson, he placed his hands on him. And he said, "You know what? I know this power is not in me." And he said, "God, one last time, let your spirit
hallelujah,
fall on me." And he began to push those pillars. And his hands were softer than the stone, you would think, right? But somehow they got strong enough to completely shove those massive columns aside. They began to break and tumble. Rocks began to fall. The Philistines began to scream, "Ah!" And they ran, but not fast enough. because that whole place fell and caved in and destroyed everybody, including Samson. That's right. So Samson realized at the end when it was too late. Can you imagine what Samson could have been if he had relied on the Spirit of God entirely?
Hallelujah.
But he didn't. He relied on himself until the very end. And at that point, it was almost too late. So that's the story of Samson. Guys, we got to rely on God, right? Yes. Now, I think we got a song. What are we singing? Oh, you need a microphone, brother. Can he borrow your mic just for a second? So we're singing a song about how we're not big, but
God is big.
God is. So,
and he's mighty.
Oh, and he's powerful. Yep. And there's nothing that he cannot do. Mm-mm. Now, I got to admit, guys, I don't know this song really well. So, Brother Danny, do you know it kind of? Okay. So we're going to sing it. So if the emotions are a little scattered, guys, just have fun. Enjoy it. And we're going to do the best we can. Sister Delaney, she had to step out for a second. And she's kind of like the one that we follow in this song. So, all right, guys, we're going to sing My God is So Big and So Strong and So Mighty.
And we need your help, too. So up, up, up.
That's right.
My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. In the beginning, God made everything. God simply spoke and the world came to be. He sent a flood and made everything new. He parted the sea and let his people walk through. He helped a boy bring a giant right down. Joshua marched the walls bound to the ground. These acts of power are worthy of praise. But if you want to question my God and his way, I'll look you in the eye and say, my God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. Though we are sinners, he still gave us worth. God sent his son to live here on the earth. He healed the sick, he made blind men see. He let the lame walk and he set the world free. He died on a cross and he rose from the grave. He conquered sin, he is mighty to save. He went to heaven and he's coming back. God's word is true, but if it's attacked, I'll look you in the eye and say, my God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. So big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. I want the world to know about my God. I wanna live so the whole world can see that my heart has changed, I'm forgiven and new. If people need proof, may they see it in me.
Let's look the world in the eye.
Let's look them in the eye and say, my God is so big. So strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
I'm not afraid because God
is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do.
My God cannot do.
My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do.
My God cannot do.
My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. So big and so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
Yeah.
Oh my
so
goodness.
Good. I got lost on some of those, but I think they did really, really good. Yeah. I was following them half the time. Yeah. Yeah. Much thank you.
Brother Dan, I don't think you have a mic. I don't know if they could hear that, but that was good stuff. So we are going to do a quick lesson about Samson. Can you guys help me? So guys, thank you for helping me. We're going to talk about Samson today. And you two are going to be Samson. Now, typically, guys are stronger than girls as far as being able to lift up heavier things. But I've heard that girls are actually tougher than guys when it comes to like enduring hardship and stuff. True or not, I don't know, but we're going to try to determine that today. So Brother Danny, I'm going to find out how strong you are, okay?
Okay. Cool.
So if I could just have you lift your arm. You are strong. Whenever I'd tell my mom I was strong, she'd always say, boy, you are strong.
Maybe
but smell ain't everything. My goodness, mix in a shower. Not you, Brother Danny. I'm sorry, Bri. I'm not going to smell your armpit because I can smell it from here. All right, but I think she's strong too. All right, so you guys are strong, right? So you can put your arm down. You can put your arm down. Now, we're going to find out who's tougher, the boys or the girls today.
Okay?
So guys, if you're on the other end of the camera, if you guys want to try this too, you don't have to, but you can. Boys, girls, you ready? All you have to do to prove who is stronger is to hold up your right hand kind of the way you did with a slight bend in it. You can't go totally straight because that makes it too easy. A little bit of a bend to it, and you have to have it up the whole time I'm talking.
Okay. That seems easy.
Yeah, it seems easy for a while, and then it's going to get a little bit harder. Okay? So is your hand up, guys? Is your hand up?
Put your hands up if you guys are.
All right. Put your hand up. Okay. Now, I don't know about you, Brother Danny, but when I was young, there was something like I wanted to be strong. I don't know if girls have that, like they always want to be strong, but guys, we're weird, okay? Mm-hmm. Like when you're 10 years old, you're in the mirror flexing, like, I'm strong, I want to be a He-Man. You know, it's weird. I don't know what it is about guys. We're dumb, I admit. But we all want to be strong. But what we don't realize is that true strength doesn't come from lifting weights. It doesn't come from doing push-ups. It comes from living for God. And that's what we're going to talk about today. Now, Brother Danny, you know I love you, right?
Yeah.
For the sake of this lesson only,
okay,
you're going to be the guy that does it on his own. Ooh. And Sister Bree, for the sake of this lesson, you're going to be the one that always relies on the power of God to do this, okay? So we're going to see who can do this better, okay? The Bible says that he that endureth to the end shall be saved. So whoever has their arm up at the end is going to be saved, okay? So you got to have your arm up. Keep it up. Okay, here we go. So, one thing in life we need to do, does anyone agree with this, that we want to be good people?
Yes.
I think even people that don't live for God want to be a good person, right? I mean, who wakes up in the morning and go, I want to be a bad guy. Yeah. I want to go just rough up an old lady. You know, you beat it. That's not what people do.
No.
I hope not.
I know.
Yeah, we want to be good people, right?
Yeah.
Even people that don't live for God want to be good people. So, there is something about it that we want to do what God wants us to do. Now, whether we phrase it that way or not. So, that means you want to act like Christ or be a Christian, right?
Yes.
Okay, so men, remember, you're going to do it on your own. You're doing it God's way. Now, there's a verse in Psalms chapter 20, verse 7. It says, some trust in chariots. Can you guys see chariots?
Chariots.
Some in horses.
Horses.
But we will remember. We will remember.
We will remember.
The name of the Lord.
The name of the Lord.
Okay, now in modern terminology, that means some trust in chariots and horses. We're going to say some trust in cars, money and houses. But we will trust in the name of the Lord. Some people say, you know what, I got a big bank account. That's all I need. But we're going to trust in the name of the Lord. Revelation 3:17 says, because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with good, I have need of nothing. So, you know, I've seen athletes and superstars and movie stars and everybody. I think they really think that they can do it all themselves. They don't need God. They have enough resources that, you know what, God, I don't need you. And that's scary.
It is scary.
We all need God. And Samson found out today that, you know what? Well, he didn't find it out today. It was quite a while ago. But he found out that you can't do it in your own, even though it looks like you're doing it all yourself. God is helping you do it. So, are you doing okay? How's your arm?
Yeah.
You need help?
No.
No, he's going to do it on his own. You need help?
Oh, I'm peachy.
You're doing all right?
Yeah.
You're doing all right? Okay,
easy, easy.
Cool. Well, let me tell you, you're living for God. So, God's going to help you. Okay. In fact, when you get the Holy Ghost, God is going to give you something that's going to help you live for God. Brother Lee, is there one called the Holy Ghost over there that you can bring us? There should be a balloon over there called the Holy Ghost. And this is filled with helium. It really is there, I promise. Okay, here it is. That's all right. We're going to put this on Sister Bree's wrist right there. If you could just tie it on loosely. And this balloon isn't going to lift a lot, but it's going to help, right? It's going to give you a little bit of upper lift on that. And Brother Danny, I'm not going to leave you alone.
Okay.
You're going to get a balloon too.
Okay? Oh, yay. Cool.
Even though you're doing it on your own. Yeah, why don't you give that to him, Brother Lee? But unfortunately, yours doesn't have air in it.
What does it have in it then?
Well, yours says, I don't need anyone. So yours actually has water in it. Sorry. Oh. Yeah. Oh. So, yeah. Oh, sorry about that. So your balloon's helping you. His is actually weighing him down a little bit. Okay. So do you think God loves you guys?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really? Do you really? Of course we do, right? Yeah. Do you think God likes to see us go through stuff? Like,
no.
Right now, it's not super fun watching you guys, your arm kind of like trembling a little bit. That's not, you know, God doesn't sit back and go, that's funny, they're going through something. He doesn't do that.
Yeah, that's true.
He thinks, you know, I want to give him something to help. So he gives you the Holy Ghost and he gives you the promise of heaven. Ooh. Man, when you die, you get to go to heaven where Jesus is the light. There's walls of jasper, streets of gold, gates of pearl. You get your own mansion. If you want an ice cream buffet in every room, bam, it's there.
Ooh.
Is that awesome? Guess what you get? Nothing. Sorry. But you get to heaven and sorry. Well, some people say, you know what? When I die, I just kind of melt back into the dirt because that's so hopeless, isn't it?
It is. That's
but you
sad.
Got the hope of heaven. So, Bree, I'm going to put this in your hand. And that, you get to keep it if you endure to the end. And that's like the promise of heaven. If you make it to heaven, God's going to say, you know what? That's yours. And you get to keep it. Isn't that cool? Oh, and guess
man.
What you have to hope for?
What?
Nothing. You're going to rot. Okay. All right. But, hey, we're talking about heaven. So why don't we get another balloon here? This one is heaven. We're going to put that on there. Cool. And I got one for you, too, brother.
Okay. Cool. And I hope mine's heaven,
yeah,
too.
Well, actually, it says no hope. Sorry. It's kind of heavy. Sorry about that. Yeah. Here's another verse. He that endureth to the end shall be saved. We already talked about that. Okay. So you also get the fruit of the Spirit. When you get the Holy Ghost, you get love, joy, peace. Why don't you grab all the fruit of the Spirit that you can? And instead of love,
I want love.
You actually get.
Can I get love too?
Like
love.
Pride, self-love, love of self. Sorry. You also get joy. The joy of the Holy Ghost. Hey, guess what
joy.
You get? You want joy?
Yeah.
Actually, you get stress. Sorry. Sorry about that.
Man, this sure does help.
Yeah. How about peace? Oh, peace. You get stress.
Oh, I need peace.
And he actually gets sadness. Sorry.
Ooh.
Sorry about that. Yeah. How's that feeling right now? Is that kind of hurting a little bit?
Yes.
Is that burning a little bit?
Yes.
Ooh, your arm's kind of a little trembly there.
Yes.
Hey, but you have the promise of a new life to come. Isn't that so cool?
Do I?
No, actually, because you're going to do it on your own, remember? And you don't really believe that there is a God, and you don't believe that there is a heaven. You don't believe that there's a hell. You don't believe that there's any hope for the afterlife. But, hey, good luck. All right. Okay, so who do you think is having a better time up here? Anybody? I would say Sister Bree is definitely having a better time. Did you know there's something that will help you live for God to keep that arm up a little bit? And that's being around people that are doing the same thing. So if you're around people that are living for God and that are also excited about praying and reading your Bible and stuff, you know what, Brother Lee, is there anything for good friends over there?
Ooh, friends.
Yeah, good.
I want good friends to make me happy.
Good friends. There we go.
I live for God.
When you have good friends, they help keep your arms up, right? When you go to church, they're like, whoa, they're praying with you in the altar. When you're worshiping, they're worshiping. When you're singing, they're singing. It's just awesome.
So cool.
Do I get good friends like that?
Well, I hate to say this, but you haven't made the same kind of friends. You've made friends that do, they actually made fun of you that one time you did go to church and they said, boy, that was, you are such a square.
Yeah.
Oh, what are you trying to do changing your life? You know who you are. Who are you trying to pretend? Yeah. You're faking it. Instead of good friends, sorry, they have bad friends.
Oh, man.
I know. Oof. I know. Oof. And you not only had one bad friend, you had two. Sorry, brother. Sorry.
Oh.
Sorry about
Ooh,
that. How's that? Is that feeling okay right there?
No.
So, strength doesn't come from our own abilities. There's some people that say, I'm smart enough, I can figure this life out on my own. They say, I'm rich enough, I can figure this out on my own. They say, I have enough friends and followers on Instagram. Woo! Come on, I got this all on my own. In fact, I get royalties from sponsors. Bam, that's how cool I am.
Mm.
That's pretty sad.
Yeah.
But they still have no hope for the future. Mm-hmm. So, Sister Bree, all that money that I gave you, mm-hmm. when you get to heaven, God is not only going to give you what he promised. God said it's going to be above and beyond anything you could ask or think. Oh. So when you get there, it's actually going to be even better than that.
Whoa.
All of that is yours because you endured to the end. And Brother Danny, how hard is it to do good when you have no hope, when you have nobody helping you? It's hard,
it's
huh?
It's hard, yes.
So Brother Danny,
yeah.
I'm going to take that from you.
Oh.
And you can put your hand down because that's got to be really tough. Now, Sister Bree could probably hold it for a bit longer because she has a lot of incentive and she even has help holding up her hand a little bit.
Lots of help.
But guys, I don't know about you, but which one do you want to be? Do you want to be Samson trying to do it on his own? Or do you want to be someone that says, you know what, my strength does come from God? Now, Sister Bree, you did a great job. I'm going to let you go over there and you can get all those balloons off. give me the dollars back later. just kidding. All right, Brother Danny, thank you for your help. So, guys, today we have talked about Samson and how the source of all strength comes from Jesus, not from ourselves. And I don't know about you guys, but I want to make it to heaven more than anything in the whole world. I want to make it to heaven so bad. I want Jesus to see my heart and know, hey, he's really trying. He's going to make it to heaven. He's going to do the best that he can. And my strength is not in myself. It's not in my intellect. It's not in a job. It's not in career opportunities. It's not in a big house. It's not in my mom and dad. It's not in the number of friends I have. It is in Jesus. And wherever you're at, can we pray today? And this song is going to play. And if we just lift our hands and begin to pray for a little bit, can we do that? Can we just say, Jesus, I want to keep my eyes on you, God. No matter what kind of success I may have in life, God, I want to remember that you are the source of that success. God, no matter how good things are, I want to remember that it's all about you. And even if things go bad, God, I want to remember that you still are on my side and you got my back and you're going to help me through this. We've all been through some tough times, but God is going to help us make it through. And our hands may get weary at times. It may be hard for us to hold our arms up a little bit, but God is always there. Maybe catching your elbow a little bit and say, I got you. Just keep trying, keep living for me, and it'll all work out in the end. God loves you, and this song is going to keep playing. And if you want to just get a touch from God wherever you're at, just keep praying and say, Jesus, help me to remember that my strength comes from you.